It's Random Wednesday, the middle of the week, the 10th day of the month of February. Welcome, everyone. This is Father Michael, and you're praying with the God Minute. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Amen. O Lord, open my lips,
and my mouth shall declare your praise.
Psalm 37. The evil prosper. The evil prosper, but don't you wallow in anger. Do what you can and let it go. Remember the long arc of the universe and how it bends towards justice. Set your feet on that path. It is true.
Be still. Wait for God's word to speak to your heart. Enjoy your life as it is. Find your work, love those around you. Hold your head up and teach your children.
Notice those who are honest. Join the upright. Make peace where you can. Trust in God.
Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
For our Random Wednesday reflection today, I'm going to share a story about Saint Scholastica, the great 5th century Benedictine nun whose feast day we celebrate today. You might be familiar with Saint Benedict, who we consider the father of Western monasticism. But did you know he had a twin sister who was a Benedictine nun and abbess of a monastery near Benedict's monastery? As the story goes, on the story that's found in Saint Gregory the Great's Dialogues, each year Benedict and Scholastica would meet to discuss their way of life and the various spiritual challenges in the two religious houses. Since women were not allowed to enter his monastery, Benedict and a few of his companions met Scholastica in the guest house at Monte Cassino. One day, when Scholastica was pretty ill, her brother came to visit her at the convent. They spent the day singing psalms and speaking about spiritual life, its gifts and its challenges, you know, normal things brothers and sisters talk about. And when evening came, they sat down to supper and continued the conversation until quite late. Strict orders of the monastery only allowed one day for a monk to visit his family, and they were never allowed to stay away overnight. But after such a delightful day of visiting, Scholasta asked her brother to stay the night since she was afraid she would not live to see his next visit. But Benedict, an obedient monk, would not hear of such a thing. And legend has it that Scholastica folded her hands in prayer. When she looked up a minute later, lightning flashed in the sky, thunder roared, and such a downpour of rain began that Benedict and his monks could not safely leave the house. Realizing what had happened, Benedict scolded her, "What have you done, my sister?" Scholastica answered simply, "I asked a favor of you, and you refused to listen to me. So I asked my God, and he, more generous than you, granted my request." I love this exchange between brother and sister. These holy saints that we revere for their life of prayer and work were human. They came from a family, including all the realness of sibling rivalry and bickering. It's like a family road trip with Benedict and Scholastica in the back seat yelling, "Stop touching me," or, you know, "Stay on your side." Perhaps you've experienced these sibling moments as a child or maybe even a parent. Sometimes, too, this story is told to reflect the power of prayer. Ask and you shall receive, right? Scholastica wanted more time to visit with her brother, and when he said no, she prayed to God to make it a yes. And we get that snarky answer. "I asked my God, and he, more generous than you, granted my request." But what if she had prayed and prayed, and the storm never came? What if there was no rain, no thunder, no lightning to keep Benedict from returning to his monastery, and she said goodnight, and that was the end? Well, that story probably wouldn't have made it into Gregory the Great's book. I've heard it said that God answers all prayers, but sometimes the answer is not what we expect, or sometimes the answer is no. We pray for a loved one to be healed of a terminal illness, and they die. We pray for a favorable outcome to a difficult situation, and then what we dread comes true. We've all probably had this experience before. I think the power of this story of Saint Scholastica is her closeness to God and her deep prayer. I would like to think that even if the storm never came and her brother had to go away, her intimate relationship with God would have told her that her prayer was heard, but it was answered in a different way. I would like to think that even though disappointed, she would trust in God's will, and who knows? Maybe come up with a different snarky response to her brother. "Yeah, you better get back to your house and get your beauty rest, because you need it."
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we have the privilege to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Let us pray. God of love, to show us the beauty of holiness, you caused the soul of Saint Scholastica to go up into heaven in the form of a dove. Grant that by her example we may live in such peace and purity of heart as to enjoy everlasting happiness with her. Grant this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thanks, everyone, for praying with us here at the God Minute today. Thanks, Sister Kara, for your reflection. I actually was anticipating hearing more about the possible sibling rivalry that exists between you and your brother, Deacon Tony Davis, who's here in the Archdiocese of Denver. Anyway, be good to yourself and to one another, and we'll see you tomorrow. God bless.